Almighty God, we come to you this morning to listen to this interpretation of your word. And we also hope that as your people listen to the word, they'll pick up one or two points. Almighty God, you also know that you know all of us. You know our struggles. And you also know our joys. You know some of us who are carrying burdens. And you are here saying to us, come to me, all of you who are heavy laden. I'll give you rest. So this morning, once again, I'm just asking that you listen to our hearts. You listen to our meditations, and that you accept these so that we can receive the peace that surpasses all understanding. So this morning, as I share these words, I'm asking that these words be meaningful to your people. I ask this in Jesus' name. Amen. I chose to speak to the church this morning on the title, Who is the Greatest? And friends, that debate still rages in sports world. For example, since this is seasons of sport and baseball and hockey and football, the debate still continues. Who is the greatest? Who is the greatest quarterback? Is it Tom Brady or Peyton Manning? Among golfers, is it Jack Nicklaus or Tiger Woods? Let's go back a few years. Is it Magic Johnson or Larry Bird or Michael Jordan? Who is the greatest? It's the debate. I was reading somewhere as I prepared this sermon that Edmonton Oilers coach Ted Green got word that Jonathan Allen, one of his players, has suffered a concussion and couldn't remember who he was. Coach Green said, tell him he's Wayne Gretzky. Because remember when Gretzky was the greatest hockey player? When I lived in Edmonton, we worshipped Gretzky. We called him the greatest because he was the greatest hockey player. Now, some of you might also remember Pelé,
the soccer player, whether he was the greatest soccer player in international sports, I don't know. But he was an amazing sports celebrity. Pelé was such an international acclaimed soccer that he even stopped the war. There was a war in Nigeria between Nigeria and Biafra in the 70s, in the 1970s. And we understand that Pelé visited Nigeria and he wanted to play soccer in Biafra. And we understand that the war stopped so that people could watch Pelé play soccer. He stopped the war. Who is the greatest? During Jesus' time, my friends, the Jewish religion had the same problem. The religious leaders wanted to be seen as being the greatest in the kingdom of God. They wanted preferential treatment. They wanted to be honored. They wanted to be lifted up. And the disciples of Jesus lived in that era where all religious leaders seem to think that they are the greatest. And they wanted to be the greatest. And we read in the scriptures that the disciples of Jesus were struggling with greatness. They had a dispute. Who is the greatest amongst us? They said. And we know I've talked about Peter. He thought himself to be the greatest because he believed that God gave him the keys of heaven. Who is the greatest? James and John wanted to sit on the right hand and the left of Jesus because they thought they were the greatest. They thought they were special. This is the question that Jesus is asking us this morning. When he looked at the disciples, knowing what's in their hearts, knowing that they are ruled by pride, he asked them this simple question. Who is the greatest in the kingdom of God? Who is the best? And the disciples could not respond. But Jesus responded. He took a little child and brought this child to them and said to them, whoever changes and become like a child, that person will be the greatest in the kingdom of God. He brought a child to them. And he said to them, if you can change. You see, Jesus changes the focus. If you can change. If you can be transformed. Like a child. then you are the greatest. Christ wants us to change. Christ wants us to be transformed. Christ wants us to look at things differently, not the way we look at them. Christ wants us to look at things like children look at things. Remember the story I told you about Sarah? I was visiting a home as I usually visit, and they placed before me prunes, and I ate these prunes, and I ate these prunes, and I ate these prunes. And Sarah looked at me and said, "Abiel, please, don't eat too much prunes because you'll poop and poop." Jesus wants us to change and look things differently. And the faith we have happens with that kind of change. To change our will, to change our status, to change the present. So, Strathroy United Church, we are required this morning as a church to change the way we do ministry. We cannot continue doing ministry the way we used to do it. We cannot do ministry the way it was done in the 50s. The world has changed. The people have changed. And we, as Strathroy United Church, we need to do ministry in a different way, so that we can be able to touch the community we live in. I cannot touch your hearts if I am not a changed person. I need to be transformed. I need to look at things as a new way of looking at things. This is what Christ is asking us to do, Strathroy United Church. Christ wants us to be like children. Sometimes we think children are immature, but children are not immature. What is he speaking about being like children? Christ is asking us to be eager, to learn the innocence, the wonder, the simplicity, the enthusiasm, the trust, and the love. This is what God is asking Strathroy United Church to be. To be a church that fosters simplicity, that increases love, that increases trust, that increases eagerness to learn new things. Jesus also teaches to be humble.
humility. I wrote my doctoral thesis on the title From Humility, From Humiliation to Humility, using Viktor Frankl's psychology to heal. Christ is asking us as members of Strathroy United Church to begin to learn how to be humble. How to trust God in everything that we do as a church. This is what God is asking us to do this morning. So if you ask me a question again, who is the greatest? I would answer you and say, the greatest person who can enter the kingdom of God is a person who has changed, who is willing to be transformed, who's willing to look at things differently. Who is the greatest? Is the person who is going to be like a child, who is going to call it like it is. I was on the phone with my daughter the other day, and I overheard something that bothered me. But now I realize that no, it shouldn't have bothered me, because I think the person was telling the truth. My granddaughter saying to her mother, "Hey mom, you annoy me. It could not have happened in my lifetime. It couldn't. I would never say to my mother, you annoy me." But here's a little girl on the phone. I'm talking to my daughter. She said to me, "Mom, you annoy me because you're always on the phone with your dad." Oh, jeez. This is what children are. They send it as it is. So friends, it's Strathroy. This is what we need. We need to be like children. We need to tell it as is. We need to be honest. If I've done something to you, tell me. Don't go to the bus stop and talk about it. If you ask me again, we need to be humble. I've learned to be humble. I've learned to be humble. I am a humble person. I don't trust. I don't brag about anything. I don't brag about my education. Yes, it's in the resume. I don't talk about it. It's not important. Because for me, what is important is how much you care is what is important. How much you love, how much you understand is important. If you ask me again, I'll just be like a child. So Strathroy United Church this morning, as we leave this church this morning, this is what Jesus is saying to us. We need to change. We need to love one another as I've loved. This is what Christ says to us. We need to forgive one another as Christ has forgiven us. We need to carry each other's burdens no matter what. This is what Christ is asking us to do. Not to judge other people, but to accept people as they are. And to love people as they are, and to respect people as they are, and to treat people with dignity. This is what Christ is asking us to do this morning. So think about these things. And God will bless you. Thanks be to God.